What is it that makes Nestlé the organization it is today? This company whose products are known and trusted throughout the world? The answer can be found in one simple word, people. People whom Nestlé serves and the people who serve Nestlé. In this caravel jet is Mademoiselle Paula Bonjean, one member of a great army of 70,000 Nestlé people. She's been sent for a year's training in England. One member of a worldwide team of employees who, no matter what their color, creed or tongue, are the motive power behind the development of this vast enterprise. Arriving for the first time is a little bewildering for Mademoiselle Bonjean. Travel across the free world and you will find a Nestlé man at most ports of call, every one of them operating with the same spirit, whether he be situated in a jungle clearing or the world's largest city. Here, only 2 miles from the Hayes factory, the Piccadilly Circus of the world's airways, there is a continuous hustle and confusion. At such a time, a friendly greeting is more than welcome. At St. George's House, near St. Paul's Cathedral, is the company's Wood Street head office. This modern headquarters in the heart of the City of London was built in 1959. At the center of a complex and ever-changing market, decisions are made affecting policy and progress throughout the United Kingdom. Each week, hundreds of new arrivals, customers, and business associates are welcomed in the spacious foyer. Paula Bonjean is one of many. Soon she will learn of the accommodation arrangements made for her, where she will work, times of business, and 101 other essential pieces of information. New staff are told how head office is divided between Wood Street and Hayes, and of the communications which link the two centres into a harmonious unit. At induction courses, talks are given on company organisation and the ramifications of this worldwide operation. It's equally important to know about the company's products and how they've developed and increased since Henri Nestlé, the enterprising Swiss chemist, opened his first plant in 1868. At work and play throughout the world, Nestlé employees are much the same. New members are invited to join the sports and social club. Most sporting activities are catered for at Hayes, like tennis. The standard is high. Young people throughout the country are encouraged by our company, who sponsor an annual tournament. The cricket team has an enthusiastic following. Bowls is one of the most popular sections. For some, table tennis is a serious pastime. Archery still flourishes in England's green and pleasant land. The customer service department deals with the day-to-day problems and queries arising from over 100,000 outlets. It forms a link with the representatives, each relying on the other's ability and judgment. Mrs. Welsh is a sales correspondent working in a man's world. In close contact with a diversity of customers, her thoughts turn for a moment to a sales promotion project that has occupied her mind for some time. Far from the office, her imagination momentarily dwells on a new selling scheme. Is the idea worthy of further consideration? The suggestion scheme provides an opportunity for anyone to assist in the company's forward march. Mrs. Welsh knows too that if her idea is adopted, she will receive appropriate financial reward. No suggestion is ever rejected without a careful study. Ideas are the cornerstones of any project. We must keep a receptive mind at all times. The original idea may in fact be developed far beyond the original conception. The Wood Street showroom, with its showcases and colourful product displays, has seen the planning of many a new venture. Merchandising plays a vital part in the production of our products, and Mrs. Welsh has foreseen this. Many questions must first be answered. How adaptable is it? What will it cost? Is it acceptable and useful to the store manager? Will the public buy more because of it? This is a display of fruit tips, fast selling, only one of a variety of delicious sweets manufactured in our new Michelover factory. Here at Michelover, sugar in bulk arrives at the plant. Lorries like this one must keep up a continuous supply. Many of our own lorries are also in constant use, transporting different raw materials. There's no tiresome handling here. The sugar goes along this chute, straight into huge storage vats. At Michelover are produced many different types of sugar confectionery. Flavours to delight even the most fastidious palate. From this one mix will come approximately 540 sticks for the confectioner's counter. A single machine, working to capacity like this one, produces 40 sticks a minute. The schoolboy's dream, cascades of glittering, mouth-watering refreshment. Not a speck of dirt is tolerated. The modern trend to handy packs for the pocket or handbag is reflected in these fruit drop packs. Some of today's most up-to-date machinery speeds chocolate biscuits along the packing line. The boxes are specially corrugated to withstand even the most hectic handling when they leave the factory. The company employs a specialist department whose main task is to design packaging suitable for every product. From Derbyshire to Wiltshire, Staverton, where the rich Wiltshire accent of the local dairy farmers almost equals the richness of the pasture land itself, famous for the quality of its milk-producing cattle. A condensery of average size requires 10,000 cows within a radius of 50 miles. Supplies must be unceasing, regular, and abundant. Each churn is automatically washed and sterilized before returning to the farmer. The milk is carefully weighed in the double weigh bowl, and it undergoes rigorous bacteriological tests before ever reaching the vacuum pans. Already sterilized and absolutely pure, the milk is now gently condensed. Because of the vacuum, milk boils at a very low temperature. This ensures that all the rich goodness is retained. In a condensery, two-thirds of every day is spent in the meticulous cleaning of equipment. For every tin of Nestle's milk, 10 gallons of water is used for cleaning. Ideal milk undergoes the same stringent tests and controls. It's manufactured in continuous evaporating equipment known as the first and second effect evaporators. The system is one of the most up-to-date developments. Ideal milk is evaporated, homogenized, and then sterilized. Unlike Nestle's sweetened condensed milk, it's sterilized after canning, and the process allows an unending flow to the labeling and packing machines. The cases are automatically glued and sealed. Nowadays, forklift trucks are used to speed supplies. 300 lorries ply between our condenseries, factories and depots. The Hayes factory and offices, the original home of Nescafe, and also the centre of the company's chocolate and confectionery production. Today, we owe the pleasures of chocolate eating to one Señor Quetzalcoatl, honoured in Mexico as the mighty lord of the moon and winds, who is said to have discovered cacao trees on the empyrean estates of the sons of Apollo some centuries ago. Mythology may have been associated with the beginning of the chocolate story, but the tremendous resources and research which go into the manufacture of chocolate today are very much a fact. Far from its natural habitat in equatorial regions, the cocoa bean is slowly roasted. Another stage in the process from bean to block. Lines of refiners hum unceasingly. Milky bar in the making, known and loved by children and adults alike. Since 1956, when Milky Bar was reintroduced, these machines have transported thousands of miles of this refined powder to the conching machines in the floor below. The conching machines never stop. Day and night, the granite rollers pound to and fro. Each mix is conched to ensure smooth eating for all Nestle's bars. Now the rhythm changes. Molding machines vibrate, leveling out each bar into a perfect shape. After inspecting the blocks for weight and appearance, they're wrapped and packed into display outers by hand. The camera has not been speeded up for this shot. Confections of every conceivable shape move inexorably towards the enrobers. Confections destined not only for Great Britain, but for people all over the world. A curtain of chocolate covers each molded centre. Designs are delicately added by using marking forks. From here, the finished chocolates go through refrigeration units which finally harden the couverture. Homemade, undoubtedly one of the most consistently popular assortments. Any piece, even slightly below the necessary high standard, is promptly rejected and replaced. Every box is weight checked. No lightweight is possible. As with so many other products, Nestlé are first in a new field. We are first to pack chocolates in the modern flip-top crush-proof pack. The daily conducted tours of the factory are always popular. These are 2-ounce Nescafe cans, each hustling along, pushing and shoving, trying to jump the queue, as if in some endless headlong race. Instant coffee, the symbol of 20th century man. No time to wait, must hurry along. Nescafe is made by brewing several thousand gallons of coffee at a time, then rapidly extracting the water. Exciting campaigns promote ever-increasing sales. The These cans advertise a special consumer offer designed to bring more and more into every household. Tasting is the sure way of telling really good coffee. All the requirements of aroma and flavor can be discerned by an expert taster. The control laboratory conduct tests on every brew. pH readings show the amount of acidity, and many other tests ensure the continuing high quality which customers have learned to trust. Paula Bonjean, already a trained key punch operator, has taken her place in the invoice processing department. Every new offer, every price change, has to be recorded in this section and translated into the language of punch cards understood by the accounting machines. The machines are fast and efficient. Tabulators of this type print up to 600 invoices an hour. Cards are sorted in the twinkling of an eye. Mechanization has its place in almost every branch of business. The typing department at Hayes is a dramatic example. A remote dictation system saves considerable time and effort. Dictation is picked up at this central point. Completed belts are placed into folders together with the monitoring slips. Highly trained audio typists deal with each belt in rotation. No more trudging from office to office. Electric typewriters require less physical effort and enable the girls to maintain greater concentration. How about this for time saving? Every floor in the Wood Street offices is served by this Servex machine. Just place your mail in the elevator, press a button, and delivery is made to any predetermined point. The packages arriving in the post department are sales bulletins. Sales bulletins keep each of our representatives informed of important promotions and policy decisions. These bulletins are conveyed between Wood Street and Hayes by the twice daily messenger service. All post intended for the sales force is collected here in hundreds of pigeonhole files. Each bears the representative's name and contains the day's mail. Invoices are machine folded and then fed into the Kern machine seen in the foreground. This not only places the invoice into an envelope, but also includes an advertising insert and then seals the envelope down. Mr. Alan Price, our Bournemouth representative, invariably reads his mail at breakfast. Wife Frankie often protests, but it's no use. Salesmen seem determined to live with their work. The ideal milk bulletin will be useful, a useful aid to selling. The early bird catches the worm, they say. Another day begins for Mr. and Mrs. Price. No one gets far without enthusiasm, least of all a salesman, and Alan Price has always had plenty of this. Experienced demonstrators are an integral part of a sales organization. There's no better way of selling any food product. Let the customer sample it for himself. The tough, hard-hitting salesman of American films no longer exists. Perhaps he never did. Certainly Nestlé salesmen act not only as salesmen, but as advisors. They offer a service, bring news of new ideas in merchandising. Mr. Marfleet, the confectionery representative, is equally well equipped for his highly competitive and arduous job. A prominent display always sells the goods. Customers will find this display of Nestle's Royals particularly appealing. The packet has been designed to make a maximum impact. Saturday morning and the weekly shopping. But today is different. Our Mrs. Welsh has a livelier step. She's taking her husband to see the result of her award-winning suggestion. Supermarkets play an important role in her working life, and experience in dealing with large stores has helped her to formulate a scheme both practical and simple to operate. The Nestlé Helping Hand Competition, designed for everyone buying Nestlé's goods. The winner at each store will receive a real helping hand, a luxury party arranged entirely by the company and at no cost. Evidence of effective merchandising is everywhere. Promotions of this type act as a stimulus. No one can ignore the bold message. We know that shoppers enjoy the additional excitement provided by such innovations. The demonstrator in this supermarket may be called upon to assist in preparing the prize-winning party arrangements. Ingenuity is a vital attribute of the good merchandiser. Three mobile baskets have been used for this selling display. Blend 37 Nescafe, boldly priced, easily accessible. These displays epitomize the Nestlé story of successful selling. Standards of today make earlier salesmen appear little more than amateurs. Knowledge of the company and of the products he sells must be fully utilized. He must also understand the problems of his customer. But he cannot work alone. He has the backing of nationwide advertising. The man who finally sells the goods must rely on every single person, whether in the factory, the office, or the laboratory. Actions, even in the routine of day-to-day business, may have enormous and far-reaching consequences. Merchandisers have their lighter moments too. This has been a story of people, Nestlé people, all involved in a constant and demanding operation, an operation culminating here at the point of sale. This is the final moment. Only your efforts, yours and yours, can make this possible.